Mummy gave John some money to buy the bread and the sausages. Janet thinks Mummy is displaying a surprisingly sexist attitude. She does not say anything because Mummy has a vicious temper. John puts the money in his pocket. He does not think about anything. He never does. He's a boy. Janet and John put on their hats and coats. Janet carries the shopping basket. It is very heavy. Janet and John walk to the shops. Janet says, "Carry the basket, John. It is heavy." "The basket is heavy, John. Carry the basket." John says, "Say please." John can be very irritating. Janet leans in and out. Janet counts to 10. Janet says, "Please carry the basket, John. Carry the basket, please." John looks at her. John looks at Janet. John says, "Why should I?" John sniggers. John is very pleased with himself. John can be very irritating. "Carry the basket," Janet says. "Carry the basket, John." "If you don't carry the basket," Janet says, "I will tell Mummy what you did with Mary behind the bike shed." John carries the basket. John and Janet walk to the shops. John is quiet. John is not smiling. Janet is quiet. Janet never smiles. Janet and John go into Mr. Green's shop. John asks Mr. Green for bread. John asks Mr. Green for sausages. Mr. Green gets the bread. He gets the sausages. While Mr. Green is getting the bread and getting the sausages, Janet gets 20 Benson and Hedges. And 2 bottles of Alcon Pop. Janet puts them in her pockets. Janet has big pockets. Janet is a big girl. Janet has done this before. Janet likes shopping. John pays Mr. Green for the bread. John pays Mr. Green for the sausages. "Thank you, Mr. Green," says John. "Thank you for the bread. Thank you for the sausages." Janet and John walk down the street. Outside Mr. Gupta's shop, they meet Eric. "Hello, Eric," says John. "Hello, Eric," says Janet. "Hello, John." "Hello, Janet," says Eric. "We are shopping for our mummy," says John. "My mummy's in the Fox and Goose," says Eric. "I like them, thanks," says Eric. Janet and Eric
Thank you. tell you officially that it repeated on me all day. Aye, I know. You know that chap had an egg on his. And all that yellow yolk running over the yellow official. That's how I feel quite seasick.
Well, if you feel seasick, we better stop at that opposite and jump straight.
Well, then where's the baby? Oh, well, here. It might be sardines on Joe.
Aye. It might be, yeah, but
no. Oh, no, right, yeah.
project.
Could you project?
Thank you. Awesome. Okay, so, you know, it was quite successful. Maybe we should start believing our own publicity that we're actually
quite. Oh, just stop. I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it.
Thank you.
coffin so that you can all you make sure you don't get to a coffin. I'd like you to sing the whole thing. They're waiting for their Genesis crap.
Oh.
Janet goes on stage. Janet can't remember the words.
Thank you.
struggle is for a day.
Everything for his art, Shannon.
Oh,
well, maybe.
And Brian has informed me that tonight is his last performance. Oh, yes. Everything's sort of fallen apart, so it's a kind of farewell performance for Signor. What I was actually going to suggest was that on the website we had like a fan club. Yes. That was Signor Lovis Lang, but he is no more, you see.
Legs are on party.
So to speak.
It's kind of sacrificed himself to the show, so I think that's a shame. So I do need to apologise for being every inch the person that David so aptly described in his ventriloquist sketch. And those of you who are at rehearsals will notice that not only did he come up with things that came out in the performance tonight, but at the rehearsal there was a different awful thing that I'd done. So one night it was twitching the curtain, it was a mobile phone, then it was arriving late, then it was the forgetting the words. So it was clearly this whole sort of range of mannerisms that I had that David managed to tap into. although I do suspect he had help from a certain quarter. But I do actually think that all the moaning and whinging and shouting and screaming and crying has been worth it when I walk away and I go to the to Paul's and I have people in the queue behind me saying it was incredibly professional and I haven't seen anything like it. So, I mean, well done to you. I want to thank the people generally who have been very, very supportive of everything, the people who have come along to the set building, which has been fantastic, who have looked out the music, who have helped with tidy-ups, who have put up with me talking through my ideas. I'm thinking in particular of all sorts of people who have had to listen endlessly to me wittering on. I'm thinking of one particular lunch that Denise probably regretted asking me where I arrived and spent most of the lunchtime talking through and acting out the can-can scene and sort of explaining exactly where the handle was going to go and what she was going to do with it, and then it was this, and then the can-can girls would do that. And then, to my eternal shame, ended up auditioning her monkey and